You're listening to The Morning Show. I'm Brandon Iron here on Super Country 100.1 and 103.5 in Lake Havasu. Let's go to the phones right now. On phones all the way, well, I believe from Nashville, Tennessee. I don't know. I need to find out where you are. Where are you at, Chris Weaver?
Oh, yeah, we're in Nashville. We just played here last night, and I just woke up.
Oh, well, good morning. How are you doing?
I'm very fine. What time is it? It's 8 o'clock out there, right?
It is. It's 8 o'clock. You know, it's getting late. Well, it's probably past 10 at your place now.
Yeah, by 1 minute or so.
Then. Yeah.
Lake Havasu, well, I haven't been out there in a long time.
Well, you got to come down. We actually went out to the river this weekend.
Place.
It was a beautiful time down there. And it's just, man, it's finally cooling off here to where, you know, it's just in the 90s. Instead of in the hundreds, and yeah, you can't beat that at all. For a lot of people who don't know, Chris Weaver is a singer-songwriter out in Nashville, Tennessee. Originally, you're out of West Virginia, correct?
Yeah, originally. It's been about 11 or 12 years ago now, though, unfortunately.
Is that where you were raised?
Yeah, I was born in Grafton, West Virginia. Sure was.
Man, that's a beautiful, beautiful country back there. You have to go back at all, or just pretty much stay in Nashville full-time?
No, I'm in Nashville full-time now.
All
my family and stuff's back there, so I head back a few times a year, but not much else. I mean, it's a beautiful state because nobody lives there, so it's pretty
absolutely.
Cool.
Yeah. Well, you've been doing the Nashville scene for a long time. You've definitely cut your teeth in the city, and it's fun hanging out with you in the city because everyone down there seems to know you. Tour schedule this year has been extensive. You had a show pretty much every other day through September. That's just crazy. And now October, October 2nd, 3rd, 4th, now the 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. You have a show every other day, and they're all in different states. Literally, you're going all over the country. Your next show is in Indiana, and then Wisconsin, and then Iowa, and then Indiana, then three shows back in Tennessee. How do you keep going, man?
Well, I go until I get sick, and then I slow down for a minute, like I did this past week. I don't know. I don't really think of it like that. When you say it, it sounds almost like I shouldn't be able to make all that happen, but somehow we get by. I don't know.
You're one of the hardest working acts for sure. I see you're coming. You got two nights at the Stage downtown Nashville. I love the Stage. How long have you been playing that place?
Oh my gosh, we play on Sundays and Tuesdays, so you know that's not normal gig nights anyway. I've been down there for 6 years just because. I mean, it's really one of the best gigs downtown.
It is. It's when for people who don't go to Nashville, there's the bars open, and there's acts. As soon as those doors open, there's bands playing most of the time, and it runs until, you know, the bars close at night, and different bands next door. It is incredible to be in Nashville, because it's where the country scene is.
After 11, it's where a little bit of everything is, to be honest. It's a very eclectic mix of stuff. I mean, we don't do a ton of country music as far as, you know, top 40 and that kind of thing. I mean, we do a lot of Motown and Stax and classic rock, and I grew up on 80s and 90s country, so we do, you know, that's mostly my influence.
Yeah, you definitely, and, when I listen to you, I hear a little bit of, from Tom Petty all the way into Joe Cocker. You definitely have your own niche.
Some of that's good, some of that's not good. I mean, it's one of the reasons why we have an uphill battle sometimes with major labels and all that kind of thing. But I think ultimately right now it's you know, I've been doing it long enough and people are starting to kind of gravitating towards some of the, you know, that kind of music.
Billboard magazine named you one of the top 10 acts to follow in 2013. Just having your name right there at the top of the Billboard list has to make you feel pretty good too.
Yeah, it was cool. I always told everybody that we only had about a year to make it and before they made the top 10 list. but it was kind of a cool honor. And then we finally broke top 20 on the country music road chart, which was, you know, a pretty big deal for us. So, you know, I mean, everybody's telling me I'm not country, but for some reason we still keep our head in the game. So,
well, you're more country than most of these bands that are out there. You're not pop at all. I classify you as country blues. And being a country blues artist, it's more of a traditional country sound anyways to start off. Having your second album released, American Dreamer, that's in stores now. We can find it on your website, chrisweaverband.com.
Yeah, you can actually go there and listen to both records. And if you like them, then you can buy them online or whatever. But ChrisWeaverBand.com is kind of our whole thing, so that's the easiest place to find everything.
Very cool. You know, we haven't hung out. Last time I saw you was at the CMAs, at the awards, and that was a great time. Had a great time hanging out. You took me to one of those after parties. We ended up hanging out with your buddies. Do you still, are you writing songs with any of the guys right now?
I wrote, John Stone was probably the only one I've written with in a while, which I guess that's the American, you know, American Young.
Mm-hmm.
And he produces all Lee stuff. And Chris Young is about the only ones that might have been down there that night that I've actually written with. But Lee and I go back probably about 10 years. I used to borrow his van when I was going out on the road. And his brother now, is, you know, he's trying to help his brother. And so now his brother's trying to borrow my van. It's funny how life works in a circle. But
you could tell him that, you know, Lee Bryce can buy his own van, and he could buy his brother his own van now.
Yeah. Lee's doing okay. We live in close to each other, and he just bought a house that I think he could put about three of mine in. So, you know, he's doing okay now.
Yeah.
But here's the thing about Lee, that there's only one guy I've ever met down here that I've known personally that should have get everything he deserves, and that's definitely Lee Bryce.
Yeah, he's definitely, he's been doing it a long time, but like I said, it's just a matter of time. I think anyone who sticks in as much time as you guys do, it's just a matter of time until you break. And when you do go big, you're going to go real big. Lee seems to be doing great. Your other good friend, Jared Niemann, he's down there. He's writing for everybody. What's funny is you guys are in that little niche. You know, not many people classify Jared as country music, but he's blowing up the country charts. It's very cool. You know, I know if you just keep going like with the rest of the guys in Nashville, sooner or later, just all opens up. Like I said, with these kind of touring, you're going to be in Vegas here pretty soon. What's going on up there?
We are doing two private events in Vegas, and then we're going to do a radio, and I think we got a couple places we're playing out in California. And I hope to come up your way.
Yeah, you got to come down. You know, we're only an hour from Vegas, so you got to get down here and see us.
Yeah, so we're going to take about 3 weeks and go to Colorado and play in Vegas and do California and maybe down in Arizona in the month of January. I mean, there's really no better time to not be here than in January.
Yeah, no better time to be here in Arizona than January.
It worked out nicely.
Sounds good. Let's go ahead. I'm going to come up and see you in Vegas. Looks like you're playing the House of Blues and on January 13th. That's going to be pretty cool. It's a private event, but I'm going to come. I'll be knocking on the doors, okay? So keep...
No, yeah. I told you already. I'd love for you to come, and it should be an interesting thing. We're playing for a Danish or an Italian car manufacturer.
Yeah.
And it's a small one now, and obviously they're trying to, you know, make a name and stuff. And I'm interested in meeting them and seeing their vehicles and stuff. It's going to be cool. I'm excited.
It's going to be very cool. Thank you so much, Chris Weaver, for coming on. I know it's early there, and you've been very busy, and it looks like you got another show coming up. Well, you're playing tomorrow, so
yeah. You're
going to be very busy, and you got to go all the way to Indiana.
Yeah, we're doing all kinds of, I think we're doing a couple of charity things for some radio stations up in the Midwest and Northwest, I guess. So we got a long week, but it's a good week. So if I'm still alive next week, I'll give you a shout.
Sounds good. Let's play the title track off your new album. This is America Dreamer. Thank you so much, Chris, for coming on, man.
Oh, you're welcome, brother. I'll talk to you soon.
All right, let's play it. You're listening to the Super Country. That's Chris Weaver right here on 100.1 FM. Getting a little knowledge from Nashville this morning.
Shadow. Just another average American dreamer, trying to make a little me and everybody else a believer.